my name's Mina, and this is my third read aloud where I'm going to be reading Leonardo the Terrible Monster with my dad.
Hi.
Make sure you have your dads to watch with you, too.
What book do you have?
Leonardo the Terrible Monster.
Oh, that's right, you said that.
It's time to read now. This is hard. Leonardo the Terrible Monster by Mo Willems. Leonardo was a terrible monster. He couldn't scare anyone. See, everyone just thinks he's cute. He didn't have 1,642 teeth like Tony. No, not all teeth shown. He wasn't big like Eleanor. And he wasn't just plain weird like Hector. Leonardo tried very hard to be scary. But he just wasn't. One day, Leonardo had an idea. He would find the most scaredy cat kid in the whole world and scare the tuna salad out of him. Leonardo researched until he found the perfect candidate. Sam. Leonardo snuck up on the poor, unsuspecting boy. And the monster gave it all he had. Rawr, grr, ha, blaggle, blaggle. Until the little boy cried. Yes, chewed Leonardo. I did it. I finally scared the tuna salad out of someone. No, you didn't, Sam snapped. Oh, yeah, replied Leonardo. Then why are you crying? My mean big brother stole my favorite action figure right out of my hands while I was still playing with it, and then he broke it on purpose. And it was my favorite toy, and I tried to fix it, but I couldn't, and I got so mad, I kicked the table, and I stubbed my toe on the same foot that I hurt last month when I accidentally slipped in the bathtub after I got soap in my eyes, trying to wash out the bird poo that my brother's cockatoo pooped on my head, and I don't have any friends, and my tummy hurts. That's why. See, that's the thing you couldn't read. Mm-hmm. Swedish. Then Leonardo made a very big decision. It's okay. Instead of being a terrible monster, he would become a wonderful friend. But that didn't mean he couldn't try to scare his friend every once in a while. Boo! The end.
Yay. That was a good story. I like that story.
So do I. Thank you for watching, and I really hope you enjoyed it.